Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and salam sejahtera. My name is Ismailaini Ismail from Faculty of Business and Management, UiTM Police Branch. Today I will present my paper research title Modeling Non-Muslim Consumer Adoption of Halal Food in Malaysia. I will proceed with the introduction. The concept of halal food is rooted in Islamic religious principle and serve as a guide for Muslims in their dietary choices. However, this concept and principles are not typically central to the lives of non-Muslim consumer. But nowadays, there has been a notable shift in Malaysia where non-Muslim consumers are increasingly demonstrating acceptance towards halal food products. There are a lot of factors that contribute to this phenomena. Some of that is non-Muslim consumers now instigate to understand the principle and concept of halal product, where the process of socializing factors, where Muslim and non-Muslim consumers living together in Malaysia as a multiracial country also could contribute to this phenomena. Hence, this study aim is to examine the factors that may impact the purchasing intentions and behavior of non-Muslim consumers regarding halal food within the Malaysian setting. The study analyzed the complex relationship between five key variables: preferences for halal food, social influence, assurance in halal food, purchase intention regarding halal product, and actual purchase behavior. For literature review, this section discusses the literature review related to the three important predictors in the theory of planned behavior by Atzen 1991, namely preference on halal food, similar with the attitude, social influence is proxy for subjective norms, and assurance of halal food, which is similar with the perceived behavioral control, intention to purchase and role of government in promoting halal, which is used as the variable in this study. For purchase behavior of halal food, being a Muslim does not guarantee that individual behavior will always be Islamic, particularly to make decision on halal food consumption, according to Sosilawati et al. 2010. From the perspective of non-Muslim consumer, the concept of halal remains vague among them due to halal is not in their fabric of life. Although they are motivating to buy halal products, being religious is not the main reason influencing them to buy halal products. Rizai et al. 2012. To date, there is a trend that shows a strong demand among non-Muslim countries toward halal food. Banbury 2008-2011, Liver and Mill 2012. For the influence of halal food purchase intention on consumer purchase behavior, purchase intention refer to the individual willingness and readiness to purchase certain product and services. Azen 1985. Moritz 2012 indicates that purchase intention is used by marketing manager as an input to decide existing and new products, to forecast future sales, and to examine how the strategies they execute will give impact on consumer purchase behavior. Next is the influence on preference on halal food, on halal purchase intention. Preferences in this context of food refers to the choice of consumer of one food over another. This is according to Babo et al. 2014. Since consumers have different learning experience with food, it leads to different food preferences. According to Abdul Rahman et al. 2015, Mukta and Bat 2012, the findings of the previous studies highlighted that the attitude and preferences has a significant and positive influence on the purchase intention. The influence of social and halal purchase intention, a study by Wahid et al. 2011 explained that social influence is a proxy of subjective norm and also can be referred to as a social norm. Study by Oman 2011, social influence play an important role in consumer purchase decision because behavioral intention can convert to actual behavior when there is an increasing of social pressure on individual person. Next is the influence of assurance of halal food on halal purchase intention. Assurance in this context of study is referred to the certain area of benefits as regard to the significance of the product purchase, issues such as safety, food safety and quality, health and hygiene conscious, animal welfare standards and halal logo credibility are linked to the insurance assurance of halal food. Researchers argue that food safety is an important attribute of food purchasing intention and behavior. According to Nurhabibah 2011, concluded that food safety positively influenced the customer purchase intention of halal product. Next is the influence of assurance of halal food on consumer purchase behavior. According to the TPB, explained that perceived behavior control together with the behavioral intention can be used directly to predict behavioral attainment. Previous empirical studies also found that perceived behavior control may have a direct impact upon actual behavior. This is according to the Kang et al. 2006. Nevertheless, the study focusing on the influence of perceived behavioral control on purchase behavior remains an understudied area. This is supported by study by Kang et al. 2012 and 2006. And last one is the moderating effect of government initiative in promoting halal food. In general, many non-Muslim consumers in Muslim countries are exposed to knowledge about halal from their Muslim communities and will also depend on the local authorities, including respective government enforcement agencies in Malaysia like JAKIM, to confirm safety of food and halal matters. Previous empirical studies highlighted the role of government as moderator in the study related to innovation and competitiveness of small and medium enterprise. This is according to Tanio 2017, Do and Kim 2014. However, although there are previous studies investigate the role of government as moderator, many are focusing on halal logistics and SMEs studies rather than halal food purchase intention of non-Muslim consumer as highlighted in study by Talib et al. 2015, Ngah et al. 2014. From this LR, we proceed to the research framework. To get the clear idea of what is this study all about, a research framework was developed. So in the screen, you can see this is a research framework for this study, which is consists of variables like preference on halal food, social influence, assurance of halal food, purchase intention of halal food, and this study measure whether the purchase intention of halal food can influence non-Muslim consumer purchase behavior, and the government initiative in promoting halal food as the moderating effect. From this research framework, the researcher developed the six hypotheses. H1, halal food purchase intention has a significant influence on non-Muslim consumer purchase behavior. Preference on halal food has a significant influence on non-Muslim consumer intention of purchasing halal food products. H3, social influence has a significant influence on non-Muslim consumer intention of purchasing halal food product. H4, assurance of halal food has a significant influence on non-Muslim consumer intention of purchasing halal food products. H5, assurance of halal food has a significant influence on non-Muslim consumer purchase behavior of halal food products. And the final one, H6, government initiative in promoting halal food moderate the relationship between the purchase intention of halal food and non-Muslim consumer purchase behavior. For the methodology, this study employed a cross-sectional method to investigate the factors influencing the purchase intention and behavior of non-Muslim consumer towards the halal food. Data were gathered through a survey method that consists of the population comprised all the Malaysian non-Muslim consumer age 80 and above residing in three distinct areas of the Klang Valley, Kajang, Puchong and Kota Damansara. Systematic sampling was used to select the respondent with a total of 768 questionnaires distributed to the respondent. A self-administered questionnaire which were distributed to the respondent covered social demographic characteristic and various construct related to the variable used in this study. Data analysis was carried out which involved descriptive statistic, normality test and hypothesis testing using the partially least square structural equation modeling PLS-SEM. The analysis assessed the relationship between variables and examined the moderating effect of government initiative on purchase intention and behavior towards halal food among non-Muslim consumer in Malaysia. So for the result and finding, this study comprised of 422 respondents, which is 211 come from male respondent and the remaining 211 female respondents. Most of the respondents were at the age of 36 to 46 years. In terms of race, majority of the respondents were Chinese, followed by Indian. Respondents were also asked about their occupation, which most of them are students, and result indicated that 100% of respondents who have experience in buying halal food. The descriptive analysis was conducted in order to provide a comprehensive idea about the respondent responses for each construct in this study, as you can see in the slides. Next is the research model. As mentioned just now, PLSM approach was conducted to test the hypothesis and confirmatory factor analysis, where the figure show the original research model of this study. And before testing the hypothesis, the management model, or known as outer model, was assessed first by specifying the relationship between the construct to assess convergent validity. Factor loadings and average variance extracted, AVE, are assessed as shown in the screen, while to examine the reliability construct, composite reliability is considered. Next, discriminant validity was assessed. The screen shows all the items loading in a respective construct are higher than the other construct. Thus, it indicates that the measurement in this study have discriminant validity. As also shown in the slide, all the correlations values are below 0.990, thus there is no high correlation among the variable in this study. PAS coefficient was tested by using SmartPLS to run the PLS algorithm. The PAS coefficient, as shown at the screen, represent the hypothesis relationship between the construct, and its standardized value is between negative 1 and positive 1. This is according to Hare et al. 2014. Standard error was used to determine the significance of coefficient. Bootstrapping technique was used to obtain the standard error value in SmartPLS, as shown at the slide. For discussion, out of 6 hypotheses tested, 4 hypotheses are supported while 2 hypotheses are not supported. For H1, the study confirmed a significant relationship between the intention to purchase halal food and the actual purchase behavior among non-Muslim consumers. This finding aligned with existing literature. Chong et al. 2022, Noriakin et al. 2023 demonstrate that consumers with a heightened intention to purchase can indeed influence their actual behavior in the future. The other 3 key factors significantly influence the purchase intention of halal food among non-Muslim consumers, which is preference for halal food, social influence, and assurance of halal food. This is a test in hypothesis H2, H3, and H4. The 3 key factors significantly influence the purchase intention of halal food among non-Muslim consumers. For H5, the study finds there is no significant relationship between assurance of halal food and the actual purchase of halal food among non-Muslim consumer. This suggests that while assurance of halal food is very important, it may be not sufficient to stimulate the actual purchases. Instead, non-Muslim consumer must first develop the intention to purchase before translating it into actual behavior. This finding resonates with previous research indicating that high intention or motivation to purchase halal food may be undermined by a lack of information and knowledge about halal food. This is supported in the study by Vermeer and Verberg 2004. And for H6, the study reveals an insignificant effect of government initiative in promoting halal food on the relationship between the purchase intention of halal food and non-Muslim consumer purchase behavior. While there are limited empirical findings on this topic, this result suggests that the impact of government initiative may vary depending on consumer types, product and business context, according to Lim et al. 2022. Overall, this finding contributes to a deeper understanding of the factors influencing non-Muslim consumer adoption of halal food in Malaysia, providing valuable insight for marketers, policymakers and food producers aiming to promote halal products effectively. So this study aimed to explore how non-Muslim consumer attitudes to halal food influence their intention to purchase. So the result of this study could be used as a feedback for the government policies and marketing strategies in persuading halal food buying behavior among non-Muslim consumer. And the initiative taken by Malaysian government in strengthening halal consumption also could be improved by analyzing feedback from the consumer and in the industry respectively. So for that, thank you, and I'm waiting for the Q&A session. Thank you very much for this opportunity.